Hello, I'm KCRA3 meteorologist Dirk Verdoorn, and we're going to take a look at what's going on tonight with our weather and what's in store for the rest of the week ahead. But we have a pretty good storm moving through right now here in Northern California, and that's going to bring some heavy rain. We're going to have some gusty winds, and we could see some just some localized flooding and some significant snowfall in the upper elevations of the Sierra are all things that are in the forecast as we head into your Monday morning. So let's go ahead and take a look at this storm from our satellite view. And you can see we have, again, a couple of components here. You can see the flow coming through here. That's some upper level winds that are pushing things along. And then we have this area of low pressure. And you can see that it kind of pulls up and around. We've got the center of low pressure right in there, right off the coast of Northern California and Oregon. And it's this flow that's right now coming into California that's going to bring some of the heaviest rainfall. I think we're going to see some more showers come in behind this system. And so it's going to keep things active as we head into Monday morning. But that's the general pattern that we're seeing right now with this storm system that's coming in. So let's go ahead and just want to take a closer look. You can see we've got right now, again, this is currently we have, it's about 6:30, and you can see some of the heavier rain that's making its way through the Bay Area. That's some pretty good rainfall rates coming down right there. We've been seeing some heavy rain in Napa County, Lake County, and then from Glen County through Colusa County and into Yolo counties. That's going to continue to shift into the valley, so we'll see things picking up in Sacramento and San Joaquin counties within the next few hours. And that's when I think we're going to see some of the heaviest rainfall. So looking at this timeline here, you have your hour-by-hour forecast as we go through the night. Chance for rain is going to be increasing. And again, by 9 o'clock, we're looking at those areas of rain that will just be kind of more of a nuisance. They will have an impact. And then overnight is when we expect to have the heaviest rainfall. I think between 10 o'clock and midnight is when we'll have the best chance for some of the more significant rainfall. And then it's going to shift into the foothills. And that's where it kind of builds up. So we're looking at some of that heavy rain that could sit over some foothill locations for an extended period of time. And much like we saw Saturday night, we had just all that rain. We had, 1-2 inches of rain. Some spots, I know Paradise had over 3 inches of rainfall. And you get that much water coming in through the foothills, and it's got to go somewhere. So it comes down into the valley. And so we did see things like Deer Creek start to fill up a little bit. It did not flood, but it got up to monitor stage. And with it already running a pretty high from the rain that we had on Saturday, I suspect that we will have a better chance for seeing it get to flood stage as we head into Monday morning. Now, that doesn't mean a lot unless you're traveling on Scott Road out by Deer Creek, but there is the chance for some flooding. And then good localized areas, areas that are prone to flooding, are where we could see some flooding. We'll talk a little bit more about the flood watch that's been posted here in just a bit. But right now, let's take a look at the timeline for Futurecast. Here we are, 10, 11 o'clock. We've got 11 o'clock showing up here, and you can see that's where we have some of the heavier rain get into midnight, and that narrow, that's fairly wide actually, a band of rain that's making its way through the area will continue to stream through as we get into Monday morning, and then it starts to taper off and starts to clear out as we get past 7, 8 o'clock, 9. By 10 o'clock, we're looking at just some widely scattered showers. 11 o'clock, we're seeing that continue to decrease. Now, it doesn't go away completely. You can see we still have some showers, may even get a little break of sunshine before the sun goes down at between, about 5:30 or so. And rain, continues to linger into Monday night with just some showers. There's the possibility also for some thunderstorms popping up as we go through Monday. By Tuesday morning, though, the story is going to be more fog. We could see the low cloud cover, the valley fog. So that means we'll have the overcast skies in the valley and the dense fog in through the foothills. And so that's kind of that scenario that I wouldn't be surprised if that's what kind of shapes up. But we could see some thick fog there Tuesday. It finally starts to clear out as we go through Tuesday afternoon. Look at this, get some sunshine for your Tuesday afternoon. So that's looking pretty good. And then we get into next week, and then we have another weather system moving in by Wednesday. Here we go, jumping ahead. There it is, Wednesday, this is 5 a.m. Get in, 7 o'clock, so just in time for the morning commute on Wednesday. We've got some wet roads. It's not going to be a lot. I think it'll be at most a quarter of an inch, mainly, I think, under a quarter of an inch if you see some of that heavier rain like we got right here in Stockton at 8:30 in the morning. Could get close to a quarter of an inch, but again, I don't think it's going to be a whole lot. But that takes us again right to 10 o'clock in the morning on Wednesday, and there will be some snow also in the upper elevations. But again, not a storm, but just a little weather system that's going to bring us some rain. So let's take a look at the advisory. So this is a flood watch here that we have, and this shows you the extent of the area that's covered by the flood watch. And I think the big concern is really going to be more in the foothills, and we're looking at the low-lying foothills. So up above 500 feet to about 2,000 feet is where we could see some of that heavier rain that's going to cause some potential problems in some of the smaller creeks in the area. That big rivers should be just fine. That's going to be no problem. It's going to be just localized, isolated stuff. Areas where we typically see flooding could see some flooding. Valley amounts in the green. Again, we're not talking outside of that. So this is where the flood watch area is. We're looking at maybe an inch to possibly up to an inch and a half. Foothills, we could see up to an inch and a half to, again, some localized areas could see up to 3 inches or so. So that's what we're going to be dealing with the flood watch. And that's up until Monday night. But really, we're going to be able to tell a lot of what's going to happen, at least with the creeks, as we're early Monday morning, because the heaviest rain's coming in again around midnight overnight. And so we'll see the chance for some of the rivers and creeks to start to fill up a little bit. And then we go to our rainfall amount. So here's another look at the rainfall amounts. And so you can see it's going to vary. But again, close to an inch around Sacramento. We could see around an inch in Stockton and Yuba City. So that's kind of the range that we're looking at, around an inch or so in the valley. Foothills a little bit more, maybe an inch to an inch and a half. But then you go farther north and see those areas of purple and red. That's showing us where we could see upwards of 2 to possibly 3 inches. So you get the areas of purple closer to 2 inches, areas of red closer to 3 inches. And that's in Butte County. In portions of Plumas County, Sierra County, seeing a little bit of that as well. So that's where we're expecting some of the heaviest rainfall with this system as it moves on through. So let's talk snow now. Here's a look at the winter storm warning that's been posted for the west slope of the Sierra. Not the east, but the west is going to get the best chance for snow, and it's going to be in the higher elevations. We're looking at periods of snow and gusty winds that are going to be with us overnight and into early Monday morning. We could see, in grand total through Monday, anywhere from 8 to 16 inches above 6,500 feet. So again, those higher amounts are going to be above 7 to 8,000 feet. So at the tops of the mountains is where we're going to see the greatest amount of snow. But on the east slope of the Sierra, again, Truckee, South Lake Tahoe, Tahoe City, those areas, I think most will be up to an inch to 2 inches. We could see some spots that get up to 3 inches, but for the most part, it's going to be on the lower side as far as snowfall amounts on the east slope of the Sierra. So the brunt of it is going to be on the west slope of the Sierra. 7-day forecast. Here it is. This is what we can expect as we go through the week ahead. We have the active weather, so it's kind of an alert morning is what it's going to be for Monday morning. So that's why we have the little exclamation point icon on there. We've got the morning rain, the morning wind. Winds are going to taper off quite a bit. In fact, we're looking at the greatest wind speeds when we have the greatest rainfall. And so that's going to be during the early morning hour. So late Sunday night, early Monday morning is when we have the best chance for those winds. We'll see winds getting 10 to 25 miles an hour. We could see gusts over 30 miles per hour. So that's going to be taking place all at once. So it is going to be a bit stormy as we head into early Monday morning. But then as we get into the late morning, early afternoon, the winds really shouldn't be too much of an issue. In fact, we'll see a shift in the winds with winds anywhere from 5 to 10 miles per hour as we head into Tuesday. So Tuesday should be a good day. We will have the fog in the morning, and then we'll have a mix, some breaks in the cloud cover through the afternoon. Wednesday, the next chance for rain arrives. It's not going to be much, but we will have that chance for some rain. And then you're looking at some cloud cover as another weather system wants to come through Thursday into Friday. Right now, it looks like it's going to stay mainly in the mountains and to the north. And so I really hesitate to put any raindrops in there, but there's the chance where we could see something mainly Thursday night into Friday morning. And then it clears out. We're looking pretty good for the weekend next week. Look at these temperatures warming up. So we'll have to see if that actually pans out. But right now, we're looking at temperatures ranging in the mid to low 60s as we head into next weekend with mostly to partly cloudy skies. So weather, again, active through the night tonight. That's really the headline, is just how this is not going to be a powerful storm, but it's going to bring a lot of rain. So really, it's the rain. We do have some wind. I don't think it's going to be damaging wind. We're calling it still just breezy, but it's really just we're watching the amount of rain that's going to be coming through Northern California as we get into late Sunday night and into early Monday morning. So hopefully that's helpful for you, and you can plan your week ahead accordingly. And you have a wonderful evening and a great Monday and a great week ahead. Thanks for joining me, and I will talk to you.